from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from an anonymous donor from Toronto, Ontario. This Mass is offered in loving memory of their dear husband and father who passed away on this day in 2020. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves on this Wednesday on the memorial of Blessed Louise Severin Moreau before the Lord, and just like him, like Bishop Moreau, knowing that we're weak, knowing that all goodness comes from God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O Lord, who called Blessed Louise Severin Moreau to be a bishop, a pastor venerated by his people, renowned for his goodness, piety, and zeal, grant, we pray, that we may imitate his virtues and faithfully devote our lives to the service of your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At Ephesus, Paul sent for the elders, and when they came to him, he made his farewell. Keep watch over yourselves and over all the flock, of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God that he obtained with the blood of his own Son. I know that after I have gone, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock. Some even from your own group will come distorting the truth in order to entice the disciples to follow them. Therefore, be alert, remembering that for 3 years I did not cease, night or day, to warn everyone with tears. And now I commend you to God and to the message of his grace, a message that is able to build you up and to give you the inheritance among all who are sanctified. I coveted no one's silver or gold or clothing. You know for yourselves that I worked with my own hands to support myself and my companions. In all this, I have given you an example that by such work we must support the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, for he himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down with them all and prayed. There was much weeping among them all. They embraced Paul and kissed him, grieving especially because of what he had said, that they would not see him again. Then they brought him to the ship. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Strength, O God, as you have
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the hour had come for him to pass from the world to the Father, Jesus looked up to heaven and said, "Now I'm no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I'm coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost except the one destined to be lost, so that the scriptures might be fulfilled. But now I'm coming to you, and I speak these things in the world, so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I've given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I'm not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask that you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sake, I sanctify myself, so that they may also be sanctified in truth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we have that chapter 17 of John, this long prayer of Jesus. And it's actually interesting that this prayer is, of course, after the Last Supper, and it's before his arrest. But it does not have his prayer placing himself in the garden in John, like the Synoptic Gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke. But we have this long prayer. Jesus has taught everything he's able to teach to the disciples. And now, of course, he's praying on their behalf, interceding for them as they will have to take up the work Jesus left behind. And that prayer really echoes through the centuries right to us. His prayer after the Last Supper. And of course, and it's the prayer for the disciples and the apostles. And today, of course, in the first reading, we have St. Paul, the farewell of St. Paul in Ephesus, and as on his last journey. And he's giving them a long talk about that they have to take care of themselves and they have to unite themselves and to be there for others. As St. Paul points out, he does not do it for personal gain. He did not ask for anything. He even worked for his own living. And so this goes on through the centuries. And today we have the optional memorial of Blessed Louise Séverine Moreau, 1824-1901. He was a Quebec bishop, and he was called Good Bishop Moreau. Good Bishop Moreau. Not too many bishops, for some reason, are called that way. And what a title to have, what a legacy to leave behind. But he actually was a frail child. In his formation to the priesthood, he even had to leave and slow down with his studies because his body would not take it. But eventually, obviously, he made it to the bishop, and initially as an assistant, but he became bishop, and he instigated. He's the founder, actually, of the forerunner of the credit unions, looking at the world of his time, his contemporary culture, where so many people were so poor, and so many, of course, banks, of course, they're in the business of making money, and he instigated credit unions, so non-profit banking, and especially for those who have less. For those who have less, he also brought in the Sisters of St. Joseph to his diocese, and he's the founder of the Sisters of St. Martha in 1883. So he was really a sign for others to be the best in God. And again, the prayer of Jesus echoes through the centuries right to Bishop Moreau and to us, and to continue to evangelize as we go along our life. Interestingly, today is also World Day of Prayer for the Church in China, and the Church in China, the divided church, the official church, state condoned, and the unofficial church, the underground church, and instituted by Pope Benedict the 16th. I did not put it there, in 2007. On the feast of Our Lady of Help of Christians, again asking Our Lady to assist us, to intercede with her Son, the Son who intercedes with the Father, and Mary who intercedes with her Son, and hopefully that the Holy Spirit will pour down on the people in China, and that eventually they will be united in one church under the Roman Pontificate. And this is our prayer journey as we go along, as Jesus continues that prayer of chapter 17. If we read it, it's kind of, it doesn't read smooth, but it's good to sit with those words, how he intercedes for the disciples and for us as we go along. And of course, through the centuries to Bishop Moreau, and of course to us as we pray for one another in our families, as we are interceding, asking Mary to be there for our families, for our friends, for our loved ones, and so on. And so we continue this prayer. Let us bring our prayers before the Lord. Let us pray. Many in the daily TV mass community have asked that we pray in a special way this month for young people. May they see in Mary's life the courage, faith, and dedication to serve to which they are called. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray that church movements and groups may rediscover the mission of evangelization each day, placing their own charism at the service of needs in the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the faithful of China and all Christians around the world who cannot freely express their belief in Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the benefactors of the daily TV Mass, especially for all the souls offered up by our benefactors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. The mere sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of thy name, for our good and the good of all of this holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Bishop Moreau, that bestowing on us your pardon or oblations may give honor to your name, through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Bishop Moreau, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis or Pope, Francis or Bishop, the other bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed sisters and brothers, and to all who were pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ, our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not
that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Louise Zéphrine Moreau, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught, through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.